Yes, welcome to the world's only offshore video game resort. I've just been up to the helipad to coax the latest load of campers from my chopper. They're trickling down the gantry as I speak, so far be it from me to keep them waiting. I'll hand you over to the capable loins of the Games Master.
Greetings and welcome to the Games Rig. How splendid of you to have braved the rough seas to join me out here on the rig. I do so appreciate your company on these long winter nights. To tee us off, and remind us of sunnier times, I thought we might take to the fairways and putting greens of that most realistic of golf simulations, Palm Springs Open. I'd like you to complete the first three holes of the back nine in level par. Best of luck, and remember, never up, never in.
And hoping for a bunker-free experience on this challenge is Aidan Smith from Leydenstow. Now, Aidan, this may look like a very pretty golf game, but it's fiendishly tough, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very, very difficult, but I'm hoping for a fine day and some good weather, and I think, you know, we've got a chance.
Any particular holes that are tougher than the others?
The second hole's got a lot of water in it, and I don't really want to be in there.
OK, well, let's hope you avoid it tonight. If you'd like to sit yourself down in the chair, we'll get ready to tee off. And joining me in the bunker tonight is Games Master's very own Stephen Carsey. Now, Stephen, you're a bit of a whiz games player yourself. Have you got any tips for Aidan?
Well, Dominic, having watched the course earlier, I would say certainly the first hole is probably the easiest, so he really needs to par it or perhaps even birdie it if he's going to be successful tonight.
OK, then. Aidan, are you ready?
Yes.
Then tee off. Aidan is on the map now. It's a 415-yard par 4.
And here we are. You can see him positioning the cursor.
OK, that flag is the hole, so he's just gone the length of it to avoid the water. Now, what's he going to see?
He's going to swing across here. He avoided the hook.
And he's got that on full power.
100%, the bar's gone across.
It's a slight hook on this.
Yeah, slight hook.
Let's see where it lands.
It's good.
Slightly in the rough, I think. Or, no, it's not.
No, it's on the fairway, Dominic. Aiming for the green now.
That's right, he's passed away. I think he may be left a bit short here, Steve, to tell you the truth.
The bar will swing across here.
Oh, lovely little shuffle there.
Very nice. It will swing across and we have to hit it dead central to avoid a hook or a slice.
Oh, it's just slightly in the
middle. Here we go. 100% shot.
Yep, nice full power shot. And here it goes.
Off it goes into the horizon.
Slight hook here. Oh, no.
Well, he's very upset with that shot.
He's disgusted with that shot. There it goes. He's just setting up. Oh, that's
perfect.
That's good. A little bit short. It's going to just dimp up a little bit. Oh, this looks good,
no,
Steve.
No, it's going to run on. It's going to run onto the hole.
Let's just see. Oh, that's a very good shot.
Very good shot. In difficult conditions.
So we must remember the challenge is three holes in par or less. Okay, here goes. They're very, very tough, these greens here. It's got nice power on that.
Yeah, nice swing.
It's nice. It's going there. Oh, my God, we see the hole. Where's the ball? Is it going to go? Is it going to go? Oh!
So unlucky, Dominic, so unlucky.
Here he goes. Knocks it. And it's in for one of a par. Well done, Aidan. Okay, so at the end of the first hole, Aidan is at one over par. He's got two holes left with which to make it up. But the problem is now he has to get one of these holes under par. And this hole coming up is probably the trickiest. And here he goes. Yep, slight slice, but he's got to get it full power. That's it, full power. He can make this one.
As long as the wind doesn't carry it into the water, Dominic, this should be a good shot.
And, he missed the water, but he's in the bunker.
That's safe, though. He hasn't dropped a shot, at least. I mean, he really has to birdie the third shot if you can get this in.
That looks very nice indeed. Yeah. That's a tasty shot.
It could run on. These greens are very fast, Dominic.
Well, it could run a bit over then. It was certainly well struck. Yeah. Oh, it's... That was all right. He's got to get the power right, though.
He really has to sink it, though. He can't afford to miss this.
Oh, he's got a fair bit of power there. Oh, I don't think it's enough. Oh, and it's rolling down. Come on, come on, come on, ball. Come on, go, go, go.
Back.
Just to reiterate, if he sinks this, he goes two over par, so he's got to make up two strokes on the final hole, which is near impossible. But let's concentrate on this putt just now. Again, feel it 1 feet away. Just wants to dink this a little bit.
I think that's good.
Here it comes. It's, got to... yes. Oh, it's in there. Yeah. Okay, so here we go to the final hole. This is going to take some staggering golf play to take this on the par.
To get an eagle on this third hole, I think we're talking impossible, to be honest, Dominic.
I think we are. I hope he's on his driver here. Oh no, he sliced it. Oh dear, oh dear. He's got it full power, but I think this is going to go way to the right. Oh no, this could be over the trees. And it is, over the trees in the rough. We can just see in the centre of the screen the flag there for the hole. He's going a little bit wide of it, trying to obviously just get a little better angle on it to scoop it over the trees. I hope he knows what he's doing. He's slightly sliced it a bit, and this is his final shot. He's got to hold it in this. Oh, no, it hits the tree. And unfortunately, Aidan has used all his strokes, and his challenge tonight is over. Now, bad luck, Aidan. Really, from the first hole, you needed to par it. You were one over and you were carrying that really for the rest of the game, weren't you?
Yeah, I think I was a bit unlucky with the first one. And then after that, I got a bit of wind and the direction didn't go right, so...
That's right, the greens didn't run for you on this game,
It wasn't too good.
Oh, well, you had to get a good round anyway, OK? Unfortunately, no prize to offer you, but we hope you've enjoyed your time on Games Master.
I have indeed.
OK, let's have a round of applause again for our gallant loser, Aidan Smith. Our three reviewers have flown out desperate for some offshore ecstasy. Will they find it? Let's check out this week's offerings. This week it's Twanging Jockstraps Ahoy as we look at sports games. First up on the Mega Drive, Pigskin Fun with inside slots and tight ends in John Madden 93.
The teams have all been updated, all the stats are as new as they can be, and they've also included a lot of old sides which are classics.
Taken on its own, then it's certainly an exceptional game, yeah, but as a sequel, there really isn't enough new to it.
If you've got John Madden Football or John Madden 92, don't bother about this because it's just cosmetic changes. If you haven't got either of these, it's a great entry into the world of American football.
Next up on the Super NES, enjoy a firm backhand stroke with David Crane's Amazing Tennis.
There's the huge sprites that are really well animated and it all moves very smoothly indeed. But it does take a while to get into.
Very fast, very slick, not that playable. If you're at the far end of the court, you've got no chance.
Don't get this if you've already got Super Tennis. If you haven't, it's a sound buy.
15, love.
Finally, on the Amiga, even Auntie Marisha gets the chance to score with Sensible Soccer version 1.1.
Definitely one of the best. It's very fluid to control. It's easy to get the hang of.
Sensible Soccer 1.1 is a great improvement. It's better than Kickoff. It's better than Sensible Soccer, of course. It's better than Striker. It's the best football game you can get.
There are new teams, improved goalies, more cups to win, and the controversial back pass rule. My verdict... the best game on the Amiga.
Owners of the original Sensible Soccer can upgrade to version 1.1 for the measly sum of £4.95. Send your disc one plus a check or postal order to Sensible Soccer offer at this address. Gaming gurus have been soiling themselves with anticipation for the last 2 months. Well, it finally happened. We got Showlift to set up Gamesmaster Live. A heaving, sweating mass of 75,000 fanatics flocked to the NEC in Birmingham last weekend for this three-day video gaming orgy. Revelers went haywire on a riot of free arcade game spectaculars. They glutted themselves on virtual reality escapades, positively violated themselves on state-of-the-art laser beam shootouts, prostrated themselves at the latest movie tie-ins, and totally fried their brains on the very latest games soon to hit the market. Amongst all of this, of course, there were some old crowd pleasers. All in all, enough hardware and software to satisfy the most sordid of video game fantasies. Literally everyone was queuing up to stock up. This poor chap was even searching for a skincare counter. But what the crowds were really thronging to see was the Games Master himself, complete with Games Rig mock-up and some bloke in a silly red jacket. Fans clamoured to take part, but at the end of a very special day, some of them just couldn't make the grade.
They don't stand a chance. They don't stand a chance. Does anybody else think Jay's going to win? Or do we think Jay's a bit of a tune?
Another feisty feature this week. Well, I've just been down to the cabins to check that our celebrity's been kept in the manner to which he's accustomed. So let's waste no further time and find out what challenge he'll be facing.
Back so soon? Perhaps my next challenge will curb your appetite. And talking of curbs, I thought a spot of high-speed curb crawling might tickle your fancy. Lotus 3 is the game, and you have just 90 seconds to complete the particular level I've set aside. As if that wasn't enough, I also littered the course with roadworks. So don't forget to click and burn rubber, as I believe you young things say.
And for this challenge, we're lucky enough to have Lotus's Formula One Grand Prix number one driver. Please give a warm welcome to the future of British motor racing, Johnny Herbert. Johnny, when you're in the pit stops, do you ever get the chance to play a game or two?
Yeah, I've got a game gear and I have a spot of golf where I'm waiting for the tires to be changed.
Okay, now you're so good at the real thing, we haven't even given you a practice on this, we've just shown you the controls. How confident do you feel?
Not at all, really. I think it's going to be quite difficult, but I'll enjoy it.
Okay then, if you at home want to find out if Johnny gets a checkered flag or a twisted suspension, join us after the break. Back to Games Master. Tonight's special guest, the young gun of Formula One, Johnny Herbert, is about to play Lotus 3. Joining me in the commentary box is Tom Watson from Renegade. Welcome, Tom.
Good evening, Dominic.
Have you got any tips for Johnny?
Well, I think the thing he's got to do is keep clear of the roadworks. Plenty of them on this section, lots of obstacles.
Okay then, Johnny, are you ready?
Yep.
Johnny has 1.5 minutes to complete the race and his time starts now. And off Johnny goes.
Okay, well, the car's got a 5-speed manual box, and Johnny's really got to be careful, especially if he bumps into something, to change down so he can keep the revs up.
Right, all these roadblock signs, they will actually slow him down.
They're slowing him down, as you can see. They're just knocking him off. He's taking a little bit of grass on the right-hand side there. He's heading towards the first checkpoint.
Okay, he's had 24 seconds. He wants to be hitting this checkpoint at about 30 seconds.
That's right.
I think he's going to be a bit behind here, Tom.
Well, he's at about 170 kilometres an hour at the moment. The Elan on this model will go up to over 200, so he's not quite performing at this
level. He's slipping there. He's made the checkpoint in 38 seconds. He's 8 seconds behind. It's going to be very difficult for him to make this up now, Tom.
Well, I think Johnny's been confident that he can perform in this car. He's got one himself. I think he can make it all the way.
Okay, then here goes Johnny. He has had 55 seconds here. He's got 5 seconds to make this other checkpoint. He's still going to be a little bit behind. Perhaps he can pick up. Oh, he's picked up quite a lot of time there. He's back on schedule. He said 1 minute and he set the second checkpoint. Brilliant second stage by Johnny there, Tom.
Well, he was really keeping clear of the traffic. I mean, he just had a little bit of a contretemps there with a white vehicle, but that's really what's helped him make that time up, Dominic.
Okay, Johnny's got 16 seconds left. This is going to be very, very close. He's had a brilliant second half of the race. Everybody here is rooting for him. He's coming down. He's
going
got
around
about
the
10 seconds left.
Through
here.
The bridge, under the second bridge. The
Come
checkpoint
on, Johnny,
isn't
he's
far
very,
away.
Near to it. He's getting very, very close. We've got 4, 3, 2, 1, and oh, Johnny
not
is just
quite,
out of time
quite.
There.
And there
here
it was.
The
there it was.
Line,
over the finishing line.
3 seconds over time, but still a brilliant performance by Johnny Herbert. Congratulations, Johnny. Johnny, that was desperately close. Where did you lose those 3 seconds?
Well, the first section, I had a few wheel-banging sessions with a couple of other cars.
Aaron Senna wasn't even there either.
No, he wasn't, no. So it must have been someone else, obviously.
Well, bad luck, but you provided us with a brilliant challenge tonight. Another round of applause for our special guest, Johnny Herbal! And while we recover from that sterling but ultimately unsuccessful effort, it's time to go over to everybody's favourite agony uncle in the consultation zone.
Hello, Games Master.
A welcome to the fount of game-playing wisdom. What can I do for you?
I'm having trouble with Bart Simpson Escape from Camp Deverly on the Game Boy. I can't get past the end of level Guardian on level 1. Can you help me, please?
You really do have problems, don't you? The fact that the Guardian is called Blindside Bill is all important, for he can only be killed from his blind side. Simply bounce over him and bash him from behind. This advice applies to every end-of-level boss in the entire game.
Thanks a lot.
Yes, yes. Next, please.
Hello, Games Master. I've heard there's a secret room on level 2-1 of Asterix on the Mars system. Could you tell me where it is?
Heed this advice, young scamp. Simply stand on the closest platform before it flips and push right as you fall. You shall hit the wall and fall into a room full of goodies.
Thanks.
Next, please.
Hello, Games Master.
What's your query?
On another world, I just can't get past the beast at the beginning. What should I be doing?
As soon as the beast jumps down, turn left and run like the clappers. When you reach the cliff, jump onto the vine, and you will automatically swing past the beast and land behind him. Start sprinting back to the right, and you will come across some surprising saviors.
Great, thanks.
That's all for this particular bash of heart-to-hearts. I'm afraid it looks as if we might be in for a very stormy ride. Good Lord. Bye for the moment.
Now it's time for our final challenge. But instead of going over to Games Master, we've got something special planned. For tonight sees the first in our special magazine challenge. We asked 4 multi-format magazines, each to name their champion on Street Fighter 2. We'll have a semi-final this week and the next, culminating in our grand final in 2 weeks' time. So, for the first semi-final, please welcome Paul Lakin from GameZone and Duncan MacDonald from Zero.
Welcome, Paul. Welcome, Duncan.
Now, Paul, thank you. Thank you very much. Now, Paul, how much time do you spend a day actually writing the magazine, and how much time do you spend playing games?
If I told you the truth, I'd probably lose my job, but let's say 6 hours a day playing the games, about 6 hours a day writing about them.
All right, so it's quite a long day then.
It's a long day, very long day.
Okay, now, Paul, what character have you chosen tonight and why?
I've chosen the rubbery Indian guy.
Dalsim.
Yep. Because basically he's a stretchy sort of geezer, so I can cower in the corner and hit Duncan without him getting anywhere near me.
All right, let's move on to Duncan now. Who have you chosen, Duncan?
Well, I've gone for Chun-Li, the only chick in the game.
Oh, yeah, and why have you chosen her?
Well, be non-sexist, I'll choose the chick, and she's quick, so I mean, if he's stretching around all over the place, I can zap in, get a few blows, zap out, you know, moving quick.
Are you the favourite tonight, Duncan, do you think?
I think so, yeah.
All right then, if you'd like to take your games playing positions, we'll get ready to start. And helping me out on this challenge is one of the true experts from Nintendo Hotline, Keith Pullen. Welcome, Keith.
Thanks, Dominic.
Now, Keith, we've got Dalsim against Chun-Li. What can we expect to see from these two characters?
It's a curious fight, actually. Chun-Li will be attacking from the air, I would have thought, so Dalsim's got to watch out for that. Mm-hmm. If he can pick her off with a few long-range moves, then should be a good fight.
Okay, then. Are our two competitors ready?
Yep.
Then off you go. Okay, Paul is Dalsim on the left-hand side of the screen.
Duncan is Chun Li or Chun Lai.
Okay, there's that aerial attack we're talking about.
On the right, that's right. Now you can
see. Dodson's got to go for some long moves here.
That's right.
Chun Li's getting inside there, which is.
Okay, at the top of the screen, you can see the energy bars. When it's all full of red, when all the yellow goes down, they are history.
Dodson's down to about halfway at the moment. There goes the whirlwind kick there by Chun Li. It's a good move.
Oh, lovely little torpedo headbutt there from Dodson. Didn't quite come off. That's more of a short range move then.
Low on energy now, Dodson. He's got to be careful.
Dalson's gone. First blood to Chun Li. Okay, now we go on to the second leg. It is the best of three. So it's first blood.
Okay, flying to Duncan. Kick there by Chun Li. Some good punches there. Fighting back by Dalson.
Oh, yoga fire. Lovely little special move there. He's perfected that technique on the
Dalson's jumping.
Whirlwind kick there from Chun Li. Or
he's
Chun Li.
Leaping about all over the place here. Another yoga fire missing though.
It does leave him a bit vulnerable to attack once he's spewed that, I think, though.
It does. It takes about 2 seconds to recover, so he's got to be careful.
Okay, on the energy bars, Dalsim's going down again there, but he's got a little bit from Chun Li.
Dalsim's a little bit further down the energy bar there.
Okay, they don't want to get in each other. They've been a bit tenacious
staying
here.
Away. Dalsim coming in.
Oh, lovely timing there from Chun Li, but Dalsim got one back. It's very close. It's a lovely long stretchy
there.
Punch.
Chun Li's jumping out. Good
maneuver
there.
She got out of that well. Oh, lovely spinning torpedo head, but there from Chun Li. From
there,
Dalsim. Chun Li's. Oh, they're still neck and neck here on the second one. Dalsim has to win this to have a chance. And the
time
is up. And Dalsim wins because he had the most energy left at the end of the time. So, we go into the third bout. It's one each.
Decider here. Difficult to say who's going to win.
This has been a very, very close fight, this one, Keith.
Certainly, as I said, it was quite close.
Okay, Chun Li's got to get in close here, doesn't she? I mean, he's got such a...
There she goes again with that whirlwind kick.
Just caught him. That was a lovely piece of special move action there.
But Dalsim really needs to try and keep away here and go for the long moves.
Oh, no.
Good
very
throw.
Good and close for those throws, Dalsim. Chun Li's energy is down. She's got to be careful here, Keith. Chun Li, throw there.
She's down very low. This could be it.
She's got to watch one more hit, really, and Chun Li's history. She's got to watch.
She's coming back there nicely.
There. Dalsim's down.
Misses with a punch there.
Chun Li's thrown her. Chun Li's been thrown. Chun Li is out of it. Dalsim is the winner.
Good win. Surprised about that. Good.
Let's go to you first, Duncan. Brilliant start. You took the first bout, no problem at all. Then things started to go wrong. What happened?
There's lots of excuses, I suppose. I could say my thumb hurts. I could say I let him win. I normally do say that. But all I can say is I feel quite good about it because yesterday I took £20 off him at Sensible Soccer. So
Well, that's some comfort there.
Yeah.
All right, now, Paul, brilliant comeback there. What were some of the special tactics you used?
Running away as much as possible. It always helps.
And you got that grab. That grab was working quite well.
I began to get that sussed. I mean, I wasn't in the first match. I wasn't really making the right moves and everything. And then I began to get it sussed in the second two games.
Okay, well, we see you in 2 weeks for our final, but it's a goodbye to you for now, Duncan, but thank you very much anyway. Let's have another round of applause for tonight's semi-finalists, Paul Lakin and Duncan McDonald. So, Paul Lakin will be returning in 2 weeks for the grand final. Be sure to join us next week for our second semi-final featuring challengers from Mean Machines and CNVG.